Hi, my name is Jessica, your Zaun Tools Tutorials Assistant. For today's video, we will help you with how to navigate through your Zaun Tools dashboard using all the submenus we have here on your left panel. Let's start with your account overview. Under your account overview, you'll have two items. First is your account overview dashboard, which is your default landing page after logging into your Zaun Tools account. The dashboard overview is where you can immediately see all your campaigns and data. You have options to change these metrics, which is the same data your graph is using. Just below your metrics info, you have a calendar icon that you can click to change or use as filter to change data showing on your graph. And just below, you can already see your ads overview, so these are all your campaigns with metrics and data showing. You can check if you want to look at your sponsored products, sponsored brand, or sponsored display by clicking on these tabs here. Now, for your statistics report, it is basically a summary of all the data you have per month. Moving on to the next submenu we have is the ads submenu. Under the ads submenu, here you can see your sponsored products, sponsored brand, sponsored display, and rule template. Let's start with sponsored products. When you click your sponsored product, this is where you can see all of your sponsored product campaigns, as well as PGNs. You'll first see the metrics section, where you can change the metrics shown. Simply click on the X button of each metric, and the option to add metrics will be available. Next, you have your graph with the calendar icon. When you click on your calendar icon, you can filter the date of the data shown on your graph. You can filter it by start and end date, by specific month, or by range. Take note that the data shown on your graph or metrics section are based on your campaigns. If you want to see your PGN metrics info on the graph, you'll need to switch tabs, which I will show you in a bit. Our next section right here is where you can access and see your campaigns or PGN. As mentioned, you can switch to your campaign view or PGN view from these two tabs right here. On your campaign tab, you'll have these buttons available. Bulk action button, for doing bulk changes or actions, which we'll discuss in detail in a separate video. In here is where you can also see your automate campaign button. We have a detailed video tutorial on how to use this button. Next is the sync with Amazon, which you'll basically see almost on all levels and submenus here on your Zaun Tools dashboard. The sync with Amazon button basically syncs data from your Amazon seller to your Zaun Tools dashboard manually. Although the system syncs your data by the hour, you still have the button sync with Amazon to manually do the sync if needed. Next is our filters. You can filter the data of your metrics showing. We have the filter state or status of the campaigns. Next, we have the filter range dropdown. You can also filter with a start and end date. Next is the advanced search button, which we'll discuss in detail in a separate video. The reset button is to remove or clear any filters you've added. We have the columns display, where you can check or uncheck the columns you want to see on your dashboard. Next, we have the export button for you if you wish to download your data into an Excel or CSV file. You also have an option to change the number of entries or rows showing on your current page. And lastly, we have the search bar right here. That is what you can see on your campaign tab. Let's move on to your PGN or product group network tab. In here you will have your add new PGN button. We also have a separate tutorial video for how to create a PGN that you can check at any time. Next, we have again your sync with Amazon button. Same with your campaign tab. Your filters such as state filter, filter by range, or have a start and end date filter. Just like your campaign tab, you have the advanced search button, the reset button, the columns display, and the export button. The search bar is also available on this tab, and as well as changing the entries shown on this page is available. And that's about it for your sponsored product. Now, we move to the next item under our ad submenu. We have the sponsored brand. In here, you have almost the same as what we have on your sponsored product. You still have your metrics section, the calendar icon, and the graph. Now, our tabs available here are different. We have the campaigns, then your PGN product collection, and the PGN video tabs. On your campaign tab, we have an additional filter, which is the filter format dropdown. And the rest of the filters and action buttons are the same as what you have on your sponsored products. As well as your PGN product collection and PGN video have the same filters and action buttons. Now, for your sponsored display, it shows the same sections as the sponsored product. as well as the filters and action buttons, are all similar. And now let's move on to the last item on your Add submenu. We have the rule template. The rule template is where you can create a new custom rule template or edit the existing templates on your account. Watch our rule template video tutorial to see how you can create or use your rule templates created. Rules template allows you to access a set of rules used previously and make them available for copying and implementation to other campaigns or PGNs. And those are the options you have available on your Add submenu. Our next submenu to discuss is the metrics info. From this submenu, you'll be able to see more detailed data on each of your ad group, keyword, and target metrics that you can filter depending on your preference. Let's start with the ad group metrics. Once you're on your ad group metrics, you can change the metrics to show in this part of your page to show the data on your graph below. On the upper right corner of the graph, you still have the calendar icon for your date filter. When you scroll further down your ad group metrics, you will have another set of filters such as ad group name, range filter, start and end date filter. And lastly, you can filter it by the status of your ad groups. Once you've added your filter, you just have to click the search button. And if you want to remove any filters you've made, simply click the reset button to get back to the default page. Next is your advanced search button. Filters done through the advanced search can also be cleared using your reset button. Now we move on to your keyword metrics. Same with the ad group metrics, you can change your metrics shown on this area of the page. You still have the graph along with the calendar icon to filter your graph data. In addition to the filters you saw on the ad group metrics, on your keyword metrics, you can sort it by ad types. So you have your sponsored product, sponsored brand, and lastly, you also have the sponsored display. On each tab, you can see the keywords used for each sponsored ad type. We are working on adding these three tabs as well on the ad group metrics and target metrics very soon. The only difference in the filter from your ad group metrics is, instead of the ad group name, it would have the keyword filter. Now, let us move on to your target metrics. The target metrics would be the same as the ad group metrics. The only difference would be this filter below the graph. Instead of filter by ad group name or keyword filter, it would be a filter for target ASIN. And that's about it for the metrics submenu. Now let's move on to the next submenu we have, which is the search term report. Search term report are your words, phrases, or products used by Amazon users to search for your advertised product. So what can we see when we click the submenu search term report? We have two items under your search term report. We have the keywords and your targets. Let's start with keyword. Once you click on keywords, you will be directed to the overview of all your keyword search term. On the upper right corner of your page, you would see three tabs where you can sort your customer search terms. You can review them by campaign level, ad group level, or by keyword level. You also have three other tabs on the left side of your page, which are the three sponsored ads we cater, sponsored products, sponsored brand, and sponsored display. You will also have a filter range dropdown here. Then we have the advanced search that you can use. If you've done any filters or searches, you can use the reset button to remove all filters. And you also have the columns display button on this page, where you can choose which columns you don't want to see when you are on your keyword search term report page. Now, you can see here the detailed information of your keyword customer search term. On both your keyword and target search term report submenu, you will see the detailed metrics of each search term, such as the impressions, clicks, click-through rate or CTR, the CPC of each search term, the spend, and the rest of the metrics. The target search term has the same filter and action buttons as the keyword search term report. It also provides the same detailed metrics information in this area. And that's what you have on your search term report submenu. Now let's move on to the next submenu we have, which is the negatives. Under your negatives, you have three items. You have your negative keyword, campaign level. You have your negative keyword, ad group level, and then you also have your negative target, ad group level. Both your negative keyword, campaign, and ad group level have the same action buttons. You have the sync with Amazon on the right side of your page. You still have the columns display button, export button to an Excel file or CSV file. Show entries can still be changed to your preference. And the search bar is still available. Each negatives would have the three dots action button. For your negative keyword campaign and ad group level, these are the options you have when you click your three dots action button. First, you have the view product group. Once clicked, a modal would appear and provide you information about your PGN. The modal basically shows you most of the details you've entered during your PGN creation. It shows here the name of the PGN, the average product price, average product rating, the maximum keyword spend, and the rest of the data and rules of the PGN. Now you have two buttons on your model, the close button to close the modal, and the go to page button. When clicked, it will direct you to your product group network page. Next is the view campaign. When clicked, another modal will open and it will show you campaign details such as campaign name, sponsored ad type, budget type, the status of the campaign, and so on. Same with the view product group modal, you also have two buttons for the view campaign modal. The close button is to close the modal, and the go to page button, when clicked, will direct you to your campaign metrics info page. And the last option from the three dots action button is the view history logs. When clicked, you will be directed to your history logs, specifically the keyword all change logs page. Now, for your negative target ad group level, the only difference is with the three dots action button, besides the three options discussed, it has a view ad group option, and when clicked, it would open a modal again, and now this is with the ad group information. It also has the close button and the go to page button that would direct you to your ad group level. And that's what you can see when you go through your negative submenu. On to our next submenu is the products tab. On this tab, you can see all your Amazon products and all your advertised products. First, we have the Amazon product. In this page, you have the Sync with Amazon button that you can use if there are data or information that are not showing on your Zon Tools dashboard but is available on your Amazon seller. You can change the number of entries or rows showing per page. You also have the search option on the right side here. On this Amazon product page, you can see the image of your product, the product title or description, bestseller rank, as well as the price and brand of the product. Now, for the advertised product, you also have the Sync with Amazon button. You have options to filter with a start and end date. The advanced search is also available. After any filters or doing advanced search, you have the reset button to remove any filters, as well as the columns display to limit what you see on your screen. On this advertised products page, you can also see the main image of the product and description. The SKU of the product can also be seen here, as well as the ASIN of the product. Metrics of each product such as the spend, total ad sales, total clicks, total impressions, average CPC, average ACOS, and average conversion rate of a product can also be seen on this page. And now on our last submenu to discuss for this video. And the last submenu we have is the history logs. The history logs submenu shows you all the history of actions taken, both by you, the seller, and by the system, Zon Tools. These are changes that were implemented per product, campaign, ad group, and keyword. This repository includes automation commands, such as insert, delete, and update. For example, on the keyword automation log, you are able to see the PGN your campaign belongs to, the ad group and keywords, the bids before and at the end of automation. Under history logs, you can access 11 sets of records. Among these records contain the actions taken by Zon Tools automation engines. First is the product group logs, PGN. The logs would show any updates made on the PGN. Next is the campaign logs, and these are your campaign-specific logs. Our third logs is the ad group logs, specific logs for each ad group. Fourth is the keyword automation logs. In this logs, it will show all of the bid adjustments made by the system automatically per keyword. Next is the keyword miner logs. This is where you can see what are the search terms mined for you by the system. Next, we have the terminator logs. This is where you can see what are the customer search terms negated by our system. We also have the keyword all change logs. This will show you all changes, whether it is made by the user or the system automatically. And then the target automation logs. If we have a keyword automation logs, you will also have target automation logs to see the detailed adjustments made by the system per product target. Target miner logs, on this page is where you will find all target search terms mined by the system for you automatically. And next we have the ASINator logs. This is where you will find the target search terms negated by the system for you to avoid overspending on terms that are not converting. And lastly, we have the target all change logs. This is where you can see all changes made manually and automatically, either by the user or the system. And these are all the available options for you on your history logs submenu. And this wraps up all the submenu options you have on your left panel. Continue watching our tutorial videos to learn and understand more about how Zaun Tools works.